So this little drink, it really is a modern classic. It's swept the world and actually partly ignited the craft cocktail movement that we're seeing today. It really did. It got people ordering cocktails, and I mean big time. There were lots of things that made it happen. And by the way, it started out as a test marketing of Absolute Citron, a flavor that they thought, and one of the first vodka flavors in the modern vodka world, because flavored vodka goes back 400 years. Matter of fact, the early vodkas were all flavored, but this particular flavor they thought would appeal to women. And they were test marketing in one case in Miami. So they went to some female bartenders on the Strip, South Beach. And they found a woman named Cheryl Cook, and they tasted around it, and they said, could you make something? And so she basically took two popular drinks of the day, a kamikaze and a lemon drop, put them together kind of, Rose's lime juice, a little sweet and sour, which was what everybody was using in those days. The fresh movement hadn't really kicked in yet. In a big way. So she crafted this and threw a little pink in, the cranberry juice from Ocean Spray, because, you know, cranberry juice from the Fern Bar movement was all over the place. It was in, you know, Cape Codders, and it was in all of the breeze drinks, so it was not, you know, not a big step. But it was pink and it was beautiful and it was still strong. So even a man drank it once in a while. And more as time went on, and then we all know what happened. I mean, it went to the Fog City Diner. That's because media people drank at the Fog City Diner. They had heard about it, so they brought it to the Fog City Diner. The chef there immediately took credit for inventing it. And of course, he didn't. And that's where I first had it, at the Fog City Diner in San Francisco, going in with some radio guys who were customers of mine back at the Rainbow Room. Then I came back to the Rainbow Room, and I thought, what a great name, the Cosmopolitan. What a classy. But the recipe I tasted at the Fog City Diner was funky. I thought, wouldn't it be good if it had fresh juice and some quality spirit like Cointreau as the sweetener? Lime juice and Cointreau. So I sort of retooled it, only to find out that it was being made in another big New York hangout where the sort of artsy-fartsy crowd used to hang, down at a place called, and it was the Keith McNally restaurant, the guy who did Balthazar later. And it was a cafeteria, and I'm not remembering the name right now, but anyway. It was popular there, and a guy named Toby Ciccini was making it there with a similar recipe to mine, except that I was flaming an orange peel. He was squeezing a lemon peel. We had a few little differences, but basically fresh juice and a good sweetener, Cointreau. Toby went on to write a book called Cosmopolitan, as a matter of fact, not really so much about the drink as about his bartending career, and it's a wonderful book that I recommend to young bartenders. Up at the Rainbow Room, I have all of the Associated Press guys, and they were there for second shift. This was where they took their lunch break. The year that the Grammys left LA and moved for the first time to New York, Radio City Music Hall, right next door to the GE building where we were, we had the big Sony Grammy party. They took over both floors. We had in the big room, the round room with a circular dance floor, we had three tiers. Sinatra over here with his entourage, Bob Dylan over there with his entourage, and Madonna right in the middle. You know, Sinatra had a whiskey bar, Jack Daniels and stuff like that. I don't know what Bob Dylan was drinking necessarily. No, kidding. Bob drinking, he was probably doing beers and I don't know whatever he drank in those days. I don't remember. But she, Madonna, insisted on having Cosmopolitans. So they're all drinking these pink drinks, and my guy for the Associated Press takes a picture. He calls me later that night and he says, Dale, what's that drink that Madonna's drinking? I'm going to put it out on the wire. I said, here's what I want you to say. Madonna drinking the Cosmopolitan at the world famous Rainbow Room. Done, he said. Well, I mean, it went out everywhere. Because like for a week, I'm getting phone calls. Germany, what is this drink Madonna was drinking? You know, and I was giving the recipe out to everybody. But of course, in Europe at the time, they didn't have any cranberry juice. So using cloudberry juice or whatever they can get that was red and kind of tart. I get a call from Australia, you know, hi, mate. And then Absolute hires me. This guy named John Beach was hired by Seagram's, who owned Absolute in those days, to bring Absolute to the UK. By the way, Absolute was pretty much exclusively in America at the time, United States. And he says, Dale, I want you to come over. I know that you're this drink, the Cosmopolitan, I want you to come over and make them, and I want you to be a judge in a cocktail contest, and I want you to be a guy over here and do a seminar, you know. So we served 150 Cosmopolitans for this, in Atlantic Bar and Grill, this fancy cocktail bar that Dick Bradsell, the sort of you know, lead bartender in the UK, and I'm flaming 150 orange peels, and the bartenders are like, oh, that's cool, man. Again, no cranberry juice. We're using cloudberry, whatever we had. Then I get a call from Ocean Spray. Would I help them roll out cranberry juice in the UK? I'm like, I love this drink. It's turned into a cottage industry for me by now, right? Not to mention the fact that up at the room, when I started flaming the orange peel, that sort of came the, this became the franchise. Everybody brought people up. You gotta see what this bartender's doing, flaming this. You gotta see it, you know. And I'm sending people home with their house parties, how to flame the orange peel. And so everybody thought I invented it. I said, no, I didn't invent it. I had nothing to do with the invention of this drink. You know, this woman named Cheryl Cook. By then, none of us had found Cheryl Cook. And my friend Gary Reagan, author, bartender, raconteur, and just an all-around nice guy, he finally gets a call from this woman, Cheryl Cook. I hear you've been looking for me, she says. And he writes a whole interview with her, which she publishes. She says, in fact, she did invent it, and this is how she made it. And she left the business for a while, but now she's back. And now I think she's actually touring the Cosmopolitan, which is lovely, you know. But, you know, Sex and the City picked it up, and then boom, around the world. Everybody wants Cosmopolitans. So it really, still, I think, around the world, next to the mojito, might be the most ordered drink in the world to this day. You know, and it certainly did a lot for Absolut, and it certainly did a lot for you know, cranberry juice overseas. And it certainly did a lot for my career, I gotta tell you. It helped a lot, you know. It helped, well, I made it by the gallon at the Rainbow Room. Absolut, Citron, Cointreau, and cranberry, and I would add the fresh juice at the moment of service. I had gallons of the stuff all pre-mixed, you know, ready to go. Ah, salute the Cosmopolitan.